Hello everyone, welcome to a Dynamo 101 training series. We're here today to talk about Dynamo. Dynamo is a visual programming software originally developed by Ian Keough and then later acquired by Autodesk. But before we get any further into what Dynamo is, I already mentioned the word visual programming. I want to explain that really quickly before we move on. So what is visual programming? Whenever someone hears programming in general, they probably have this grand idea of matrix, maybe. You know, zeros and ones just flying all over the screen. It might be something, you know, a screen full of text, someone typing away, endless lines of code, you know, curly brackets and semicolons everywhere. I mean, that's a pretty scary thing to think about, but Dynamo is something else. It's a little bit different than that. Just to illustrate that, I want to give everyone a quick example of what visual programming really is. And I'm going to do this using Revit. Revit is probably something that everyone is familiar with, so I hope this will be an easy way to understand. So imagine you want to tell your computer to perform some sort of action. So this is exactly what programmers do. What they do is they write code, they write algorithms that tell computers what to do, that tell software what to do. So imagine you want to say, let's say you want to draw a detail line. So effectively what you do just by clicking that button and activating this command in Revit is you're telling your software, you're telling your computer, hey, I want to draw a detail line. So you send an instruction to the computer. And now it's expecting you to select a point, right, to give it an input. So just by clicking, first to define the start point of the line, and then second to define an endpoint of the line, we're providing inputs to the computer. So what happens is these inputs get processed, we end up with a line on our screen. So this is the visual way of basically running a visual program per se. So this is the way you execute a series of instructions, right? You told the computer what you want to do, you gave it proper input, it processed it, and you end up with a product, which is that line over here. So let me just fire up Dynamo and I'm gonna demonstrate to you how Dynamo deals with that set of instructions. So what we did with the user interface in Revit, just by clicking it, we used someone else's set of instructions. A piece of program handled all these instructions underneath and we never had to deal with those. And Dynamo gives you the ability to kind of peek under the hood of what is happening and define those instructions yourself, but define those instructions in a very visual and easy to understand way. So I'm just gonna really quickly show you how Dynamo would define a set of instructions for creating a line, right? So first on the left there's a library and I'm just gonna really quickly browse through it. I'm not gonna go through all of the details of what is what and where. We're gonna get to it in the later parts of the video, but I'm just gonna illustrate how you would define a set of instructions for software like Dynamo or Revit using the visual programming tools. So I'm just going to create a number and I'm going to copy it a handful of times, and then I'm going to get to the goal is to create a line like we did using the interface. So if I go over here and search for line by 2 points, so this is basically a instruction that we want to send to the computer and tell it, hey, I want to create the line by 2 points. So next thing we need to do is actually define those 2 points for it. And I'm going to use another one of those little containers. So in Dynamo, instead of typing out lines of code, which you could do, you basically have all of these instructions for software wrapped up into those containers. They're called nodes. And you can see them on the screen. And instead of typing code, you just pretty much define all of these just by connecting inputs and outputs. So we need 2 points, and I'm just going to copy this over. I'm going to define a different Y for this particular input. And then when we connect the 2 points to start and endpoint, we effectively satisfied all of the necessary inputs for this instruction, for this container, to generate a line, and you can see it in the background. And I'm just going to really quickly toggle around to see that. So this is a visual programming way of defining a line. What we saw in Revit was a, you know, something that we're super familiar with from working in Windows. It's kind of this keyboard and mouse entry user interface way of telling the computer what you want to do. But Dynamo gives you this greater ability for writing your own instructions. Before we move on, I just want to talk about one more thing about Dynamo. I just want to make sure that everyone understands Dynamo is not just a piece of software. Dynamo is a lot more than that. So Dynamo is an entire community, and the main place to go to interact with that community will be the Dynamo website. And you can access it right from the start panel. And I'm going to talk about that in greater detail a little bit later. So this main page over here gives you access to the Dynamo community and all of the resources that come with it. So you have access to all sorts of different examples that are posted on this website. There's also a community section called a blog, where creators of Dynamo, the software developers writing Dynamo, make posts about different functions and different things that Dynamo can do and how do you use it in everyday practice. So besides the blog, there's also something that's probably the most important part of the community, is the forum. Just by clicking on this link on top of the page, we navigate to a forum, and forum is a fantastic place for everyone to get familiar with. And I would highly recommend everyone, even the beginners without much experience, just come around here and, you know, hang out around the forum and read some of the posts and just familiarize yourself with the jargon and, you know, what everyone is doing and talking about. But on the forum is basically a place where you can come and ask any questions. And it could be anything from the very basic to some of the more complicated programming questions that you might have. And there's a community of people that are more than willing to answer all these questions. So forum is a great place to go, and I highly recommend everyone comes over here. So this page is pretty much a go-to place for everyone that wants to learn about Dynamo or ask questions about Dynamo, or even if you're willing, share some of the stuff that you've been doing on this website. There's a gallery section of it as well. So besides this, if we go back to the Dynamo startup page, there's something else called a GitHub repository. And the reason why I'm bringing up the GitHub repo is this is a little bit more of a place to go for programmers in general, but also it's a great place for just everyday users to again come around and see what's happening. This is a place where the Dynamo developers are posting their code as they're developing Dynamo on an everyday basis. If you're interested in what's happening with Dynamo, what they're working on currently, this is a place to go. But also, since Dynamo is an open source, and what open source means is all of the code underlying Dynamo is being posted to this website, and you have access to it. And you have access to people that are writing that code, and you can interact with them. And I always recommend for all the new users to get familiar with this issues section of the GitHub repository for Dynamo. This is where you can come over, and if you run into any bugs, and you probably will run into bugs just because Dynamo is still a beta software and is being rapidly developed. So if you have any issues, you encounter any crashes, or, you know, something unexpected happens while you're working in Dynamo, this will be the place to come and report those issues to the developer. And they're pretty really good about replying and you know, trying to help out people when they have questions. So this is a place to go for that kind of interaction with the developers themselves. I will explain the rest of this interface in later parts of Dynamo. In part two, we're going to discuss more interface stuff. But this is pretty much it. This is all I wanted to cover in this introductory video. And just to make sure that everyone understands what the bigger overarching goal for this tutorial series is, I just wanted to mention a few things that I think the goals of this one-on-one tutorial series are, and the takeaways from this series is that I just hope that everyone at the end of this series will be very comfortable navigating the what I call the world of Dynamo. It's not just the software. It's not just, you know, the user interface, libraries and search menus and, you know, the know-how of, you know, what you need to click on. But it's also the world of Dynamo community, becoming part of that community. So this feeling of being part of the community and being a visual programmer comes not just from the know-how and, you know, understanding the software, but it's sort of an attitude towards the technology and, you know, tools and as a designer and engineer. I hope that these lessons, they're going to be geared towards not just draining the technical knowledge into people, but I hope that they're going to show you benefits of doing things in a certain way, in a computational way, and thinking about problems in that way. And, you know, in the beginning it might be new to you, it might be a little bit confusing, but as we go through, I hope everyone becomes more familiar with that way of thinking. And obviously the know-how of the technical knowledge, it will come, will cover all of that, so don't worry about that. So just to sum it up, I think I really want these videos to highlight the benefits of thinking in a computational way and using Dynamo, the visual programming tool, in your everyday practice as an architect, engineer, contractor. Hopefully this video series is all that you are hoping for. So thank you for tuning in for this introductory part, and I will see you in parts 2 and the following. Thank you.